Growing up, my artistic and amazing mother and my magical and introspective father, who also happened to be celebrated musicians James Taylor and Carly Simon, taught me to think outside the box. They said, make the world a better place. Help artists to find a voice. Promote equality, inspire creativity, spread peace and love. And yes, they were hippies. They said, create, share, and inspire people. So what did I do? I became a musician. At 24, I started my own recording label and drove five musicians half crazy, shuttling them from show to show. But through it all, I felt something was missing. I kept coming back to this fable I'd heard in college. Six blind men are walking down this dark and stormy path when they come upon an elephant in the road. Each man feels a different piece of the elephant's body. The one that feels the elephant's tail says, elephant's a rope. The one that feels the elephant's ear says, elephant's a fan. And the one that feels the elephant's tusk says, elephant must be a spear. And they all argue the righteousness of their perceptions until a king comes along and says, stop arguing. Try collaborating, try communicating with one another, and you might start to understand the larger nature of this animal. So here's what I did. I created my own elephant. I collected 22 photographs that represented different aspects of one thing, and I gave each photograph to a musician and asked them to interpret the essence of that photograph and express it as a song. And then I took that song and I gave it to a dancer who interpreted it in their own medium. Then the dance went to a poet, the poem to a painter, the painting to a perfumer, the perfume to a sculptor, until at last all of the senses had been represented. Over the past year and a half, I have curated the work of 130 artists from 23 different countries. Some of the participating artists in Consensus, just to name a few, are Jimmy Buffett, Jennifer Nettles of Sugarland, John Forte, Reggie Watts, not to mention some of my select family members. We've got Patrick Corbin, Paul Taylor's lead dancer, animator Carlos Lascano, founder of Dream Life Studios, prize-winning American novelist Susan Minot, world-acclaimed director Wes Craven, and I'm not even done yet. What amazes and inspires me every day is that 130 artists from 23 different countries have given their time, materials, and talents to make this project a reality. And I am emboldened and inspired by their belief in me and in this project to make a meaningful change in the world, to promote equality of perception, to demystify the elitism associated with art appreciation, to create community, to help artists grow their audiences, and to harness creativity on a global scale. And yes, mom and dad, to promote peace and love. But I can't do this on my own. After nearly 2 years of acquiring and assembling this work, I am now tasked with the immense challenge of presenting this project as an exhibit that will fully express and show the beauty, meaning, and deep importance of this global multicultural collaboration. I need funds to design, fabricate, and launch the exhibit, to assemble the best team that I can, and to build a global interactive website that will engage and encourage people to actually get involved in the artistic process and their own expression. The artists have handed me a key. I need your help to assemble the bricks and mortar to build a door that, when used together, will open up people's minds. I hope that you will make an impact with me.